Stacks on the beat.
What is going on, people? Alright, guys.
Dude, we need to get some fish!
Going on, people, it's your boy Savage Fishing, and today we are going to be making some lures. The easiest way, cheapest way. Now I'm doing this for a school project, but right now I'm just gonna do it for YouTube. But the next video I'm probably gonna have it as the same name, but I'm not gonna be talking in it. It's just gonna be showing me making the lures, and that's gonna be for my school. Right now I'm gonna do one for you guys, since a lot of people don't know how to make Senkos and all those. But I'm making it a cheap way. So all you need is foil, old Senkos, teared up Senkos, which I have a lot, like cheap Senkos or not just Senkos, but any lure, rubber lure that you don't want. Get a bag and just keep on putting them in there till you get a lot. Now the first thing you're going to need to do is make a mold. Now the mold is what you pour your liquid in to make a lure. So right here I have a mold. Alright, this mold is for bluegill as such, and last time when I made it, it came out like that. Poured in the stuff and mold came out as a little tiny thing like that. That's my bluegill mold. So bluegill. Alright, so then I have this one. And this is my little Senko mold. At the end, this thing goes back and forth like, kind of like a swim bait. And then here, this is the mold for it. But the reason why it came out like this is I messed up and I didn't have enough stuff, because I thought it would be enough, but this stuff dried too fast, so I only got a little in. That's why the back is not as long as it's supposed to be. So anyway, let's get into making your molds. This project is only going to be up to $5 or $10. It's the cheapest one out there. Everything else you have to buy. Copper pipe. The cheapest one that I found on the internet was like, you have to buy copper pipe, all of this stuff, and it came out to like $30, but that's still expensive. If you're like me and you don't have any supplies, well, what I'm doing here is I'm gonna make a lure actually out of this. Now this was a pen and I just took out the top, and this is gonna be my Senko mold. If you want a bluegill mold or a really good mold, I recommend buying silicone, but that was just something in my garage. This one's gonna be just a pen that's taken out everything and just some foil. So what you need to do here is, it doesn't long matter how long your strip of foil is. It does if you want a certain size of a Senko. For instance, I'm going to get one of the Senkos I'm going to use to turn into my liquid. So, say the size of this regular Senko is almost the size of the pen. I already did this with the other Senko, but this one's a little bigger. And say you want the exact size of this one. But these molds aren't going to come out like that. You aren't going to have that unless you get the silicone and pour a big line and then push this in halfway and then pull that out and pour stuff in. That's what I did with the bluegill mold. I just got some silicone, put it in there, put my little bluegill bait I had, and that's how it came out. Alright, now let's start to make our mold. So you want to push this down a little bit. You want a little bit off the bottom so you can push up the foil like that. Alright. But you'll do that after. See how I have that little open spot where the pen doesn't go all the way down? So, and then I'm gonna start rolling it on the foil. And your lures aren't gonna always come out perfect. Alrighty. That's about enough. Now, from the bottom, I'm going to push my foil up like that. That's perfect. Perfect. Once you rolled your pen, the part that you had your pen in, you could just take it out, and sometimes this will be hard. But I'm gonna get it out. There we go. Right out. There you go, you got your mold or your Senko. And yeah, I should have did a video on this yesterday, but I didn't. So today I'm going to be making a mold. No, I'm going to be pouring stuff in here right now. So let's get into it. Now, and didn't smell like it's good for you, but right now I don't have any mask or anything, so it's fine for now. But if you do have a mask or something, wear it. And also, you need a microwave and a cup, like this. And don't worry, the plastic comes off super easy when it dries, which is like a couple minutes. Alright, sorry if my hair's all messed up right now, but because I've been running. It might not even be messed up, but whatever. So look at this. This actually right here came off, dried off the lure I made before because I put too much stuff in there. So we have extras to throw on to this cup. Now, I don't need this much, so what I'm going to do is take a little bit like that. And this might be even too much, but never know. Alright. Now, oh yeah, when you're doing this, you also want something like some type of gloves. So, because this thing gets really hot. So, you want heating gloves or something so you don't burn your hand. Okay, and you also want a spoon that you don't care about. Guys, if you have one of these, that's what I usually use, so it works. So, let's put it in. Oh god. It wasn't. Alright guys, that's pretty much it I have for today. This is what it came out to. And then you just add a little jig head on it. There you go, this one is kind of messed up though. But that guarantee will catch you a bluegill. So that's all I have for today. If you guys want to see the Senko that I made, I could try to make that again. Fishing, never stop. Do what you're born to do. Fish. And fishing only comes easy to those who try. Savage fishing here.